morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie. It is Thursday, and it's already feeling like a good day in the studio. I feel good about the stuff I got done yesterday. I feel excited about the things that I'm going to get done today, and I'm really looking forward to the things that are on tap for tomorrow. And what a great way to spend a Thursday. So the podcast is officially back today. Yay! With an episode where I interview Natasha Riley from Creative Nachos. And we had so much fun talking about creative risk, creative play, creative bravery. And Natasha was great to talk to, and I know you're going to love this interview with her. Yesterday, I also interviewed Molly Gordon for an upcoming episode of the podcast, so be sure to keep your ear out for that. And okay, so this ties into it's a segue from the podcast to what I'm up to today. Yesterday, I invited Teresa Reed, the Tarot Lady, to be on Creative Living with Jamie, and she gave me a resounding yes. Hey, Teresa! And that is so great because I'm really excited about our current conversation about the relationship between tarot and creativity. And today, here's the segue, I'm going to be completing my video series of flipping through my four core tarot decks so that on Sunday, when you get your newsletter as a member of the studio, you're a member of the studio, right? then you'll have access to all four of the flip throughs. So I'm really excited about putting that together and getting the newsletter together today because tomorrow I'm kind of taking the day off. I should still be here for the behind the scenes. I have time to do that. But afterwards, Shannon and I are meeting up with our Auntie Lima and we are going on a creative adventure. I'll tell you all about it on Monday. My Auntie Lima is the one who is helping me with my foray into sewing. And you know, it kind of fizzled, didn't it? You haven't heard about it for a long, long time. And I should write about that because what happened was I don't have a great place to leave the sewing machine up all the time, and setting it up and taking it down and setting it up and taking it down all the time just was more of a hassle. And so I'm in the new year, I plan on figuring out a way to have a little sewing station, and I'm gonna give it a solid try. And I may move to some easier projects. My Auntie Lima recommended pillowcases as a great place to start and work my way up to the dress that I had started. So I haven't forgot about that project, it's just on hold. But here we are on the first of October. And so I'm thinking about the projects that are not on hold, but the projects that are just about to begin. What are you dreaming up for October? Have you thought about it? Did those fall journal questions that I shared with you, did they help bring into focus the projects you want to bring to life? Have you chosen one or some for this month? I've got a big one coming out in November, and so that means doing all the work in October. It is something that has been on my mind for almost, I don't know if it's 2 or 3 years now, but it is the first ever Jamie Riddler Studios Do Good initiative. And the basic concept of it is that I want to get as many journals as possible into the hands of as many girls as possible. And this was really reinforced this year when I spoke at G-Day and taught a whole slew of 10 to 12 year old girls what it means to journal. I just looked at their faces and knew that this project, this little seed that had been in my heart for years now, that now was the time. It's going to be a very simple initiative. There'll be basically two ways that you can participate. The first is that you're going to be able to give a girl a journal. When you order a journal for a girl, we'll put together a beautiful package. We'll put together some instructions about how to journal and that there's no way you can get it wrong. And we will send it off to a girl that is waiting for her benefactor to get a journal in her hands. On the other side of things, you'll be able to nominate a girl or girls for receiving journals. So it could be anyone. It could be your daughter. It could be your niece. It could be your neighbor. It could be your girl guide troop. It could be the girl that you sponsor through foster care. Any girl can be nominated, and we'll just keep matching girls who want a journal, who've been nominated for a journal, to people who are going to give a girl a journal. I'm really excited about this initiative. I hope you are too. Journaling is at the heart of so many of our creative lives, and it has helped so many of us find our voice and find our truth. And I want that to be available to girls everywhere. And the beautiful thing is, it's so simple. All you need is something to write with and something to write on. That's it. You and your journal can find the truth. The other thing that's going on in October that I promised is that I am going to host a collage image giveaway. So I'm going to make 7 packages of all sorts of beautiful images that you can use on your dream board or in your journal or in your art journal. Colors, shapes, animals, all sorts of beautiful things. I know one of the things that inspired this is a lot of times when people see my dream boards, and I shared mine with you yesterday, they say, "Where did you get those images?" And so I have a whole bunch of beauties that I would love to give away to you. And what we're going to do is I'm going to host a contest, and all you have to do is take something from the behind the scenes that really inspired you, that moved you, that you're pondering, and you'll get 1 entry if you send it to me. You'll have an opportunity for another entry if you share it out in the world. So on Facebook or Twitter or Pinterest even. So you can start gathering now, but I'll open the contest on October the 15th and close it on Halloween, October 31st. Announce the winners on the 1st and get the packages of collage images out the next week after that. I hope that sounds fun and exciting to you. I am so excited to put these packages together. Between the journals and these packages, I feel like I'm getting presents ready. Have a great day in your studio. Think about what you want to bring to life this October. What are you dreaming of? What are you going to create? What are your goals and priorities for this month? Feel free to share with me. I love to hear. Leave me a comment below. I always check them out. Okay, have a great day, and I will see you tomorrow.